And later, the 1989 World Series begins as the San Francisco Giants meet the Oakland A's in Game 1. That's all coming up beginning next with ABC's College Football. The following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
Hi, everybody. I'm Roger Twybill in our ABC studios in New York. To remind you again, 8 o'clock Eastern time, first game of the World Series from the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum. Couple of right-handers on the mound tonight. Scott Gerelts for the Giants. Dave Stewart with his third straight 20-win season for the Oakland A's. Let's get you caught up on some college football scores. First of all, the Buffs of Colorado scored on their first 8 possessions. They lead at 52-10 in the fourth quarter. Nebraska easily over Missouri. That game now in the second. The upset of the day coming down in Clemson at homecoming. Georgia Tech leads in the fourth quarter. A final, Florida State has beaten Virginia Tech. Peter Tom Willis, 3 touchdown passes there. And from the Big Ten, Ohio State 35 and Indiana 21. I'll be back throughout the day with scores and highlights. Now it's college football here on ABC.
Going to work to have fun today in the state of Michigan. The guest is traveling a modest distance in comfortable accommodation. You didn't sense a great deal of levity in this group as they departed Ann Arbor this morning, however. The gathering place is East Lansing, just east of the state capitol. The host is walking to work, not exactly showing a thigh-slapping sense of humor either. But in a little while, they will all be happier running, passing, and tackling. It's the Wolverines and the Spartans. It's Bo and George. It's Michigan and Michigan State. One more time. The primary colors around East Lansing, Michigan, most of the time are green and white. But every autumn, for a glorious few days, Spartan colors yield to Mother Nature's palette. And today, it looks like this. Inside the stadium, of course, it's all green and white. As it should be, because this is the home of the Spartans, the Michigan State Spartans. And Bob Greasy, this is a lunch bucket game. This is a hard hat overall game. It's a game for the big uglies where you can roll around in the mud and the blood.
The physical game is what you're trying to say. If you like defense and you like physical football, you're in for a good one. Defense is the name of the game. The team that has won this game has gone to the Rose Bowl the last 3 years. The team that is the best defensive team in the Big Ten wins the Big Ten title. Two top teams here. Michigan does it with a team style of defense. They currently are number one in the league in defense. But none of their players are in the top 20 of the defensive tacklers individual-wise in the conference. Michigan State, on the other hand, does it with one middle linebacker, a dominant player in Percy Snow. Snow is the leading tackler in the Big Ten. In fact, has twice as many tackles as any Michigan player.
All right, the Wolverines now gathering at the end of the stadium to come bolting out of the tunnel. They are 3-1 on the year, 1-0 in the Big Ten, ranked 5th in the national polls. Bo Schembechler in his 21st season, and he is 16-4 against Michigan State. In this particular ballpark, he lost his first time up here, and then he lost the last time he came up here, which was 1987. And that victory for Michigan State was a game that triggered them on their way to Pasadena and the Rose Bowl. So the Michigan Wolverines touted at the beginning of the year as the possible number one team. But there's one thing about this Michigan bunch today, Bob. They come out here with an unusual element in that they can show you two different offenses.
Well, they have their fifth-year senior quarterback back healthy, ready to play. Michael Taylor, who is an option-style quarterback, is back ready to play. They also have Elvis Gerbach, who replaced him in the first game against Notre Dame and has done very well. In fact, Gerbach leads the Big Ten quarterbacks in passing efficiency. Bo has exactly what he wants. He has a different style, contrasting styles. He has an option quarterback and a passing quarterback, and that creates problems for the Michigan State defense.
The roar, as as Michigan State Spartans come bolting out of the tunnel. They almost ran over Michigan in their haste to get out here. Their record is 2-2. They lost a couple of tough, close games to Notre Dame and Miami. They defeated Iowa by 3 points last week. George Perlis is in his seventh season. He's 2-4 against Michigan. And the series record for these two teams reflected here shows a 30-game edge for the Michigan Wolverines. And as we told you, the last time they played here, Michigan State won. Last year down at Ann Arbor, it was a 14-point win for the Michigan Wolverines. So we're ready to play between the Wolverines and Spartans. And as we said,
they got to work. There was no emotion at all in the pregame rituals. They went about it in a workmanlike manner, but they showed no emotion at all. They know this is going to be a hard physical test. Even running out onto the stadium, none of them showed the exuberance that many see in a college football game. They know this is going to be a blue-collar type of day, Keith.
This, without question, has been the prettiest trip for me ever to East Lansing, and I think I came here first in 1957 for football. There has been not a single drop of rain. The foliage around the area is at its absolute, ultimate, glorious best. It is warm, 82 degrees today. It's just a remarkable weekend of weather for one of the old traditions in college football, Michigan State and Michigan.
What you're trying to say is it's a perfect college weekend.
Just east of the state capital. Both teams definitely contenders for the Big Ten championship. See, Bo's had some good times here and at home against the interstate rivals in cross-state. George Perlis, of course, gained his initial fame as an assistant coach with Chuck Knoll and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And today, when you watch Michigan State play defense, you're going to remember watching the Steelers play the same defense, a defense that took them to all of those Super Bowls. And these youngsters play that defense pretty well here in East Lansing. J.D. Carlson is going to kick it off to Courtney Hawkins. He's the deep man. Hawkins is a wideout, sophomore from Flint, Michigan. He's back there by himself, and the two men on the side are well up the field. They are 20 yards from him. So he literally has nobody in the immediate vicinity in case that kick might be hooked or veer off to one side or the other. Hawkins has just simply got to go run it down. That's a high, deep kick by Carlson. Must be getting some help from the wind, which is whirling around, and Hawkins comes across the 20 and gets back to about the 23. So that's where Michigan State will go to work. Michigan, having won the toss, elected to take the second half kickoff instead. And the man who opens at quarterback for Michigan State, you can see his passing completion mark in percentages, and as his coach George Perlis said yesterday, you hit 20 out of 25 against the wind, that's pretty good. And he's right. From the 23, here we go. Man in motion is number 3. That's James Bradley, a junior college transfer, and they're going to run it. Michigan State loves to send that tailback, and Blake Ezor will move it up near the 30-yard line. The offensive backfield for Michigan State, Enos is your quarterback, 6'1", 190, a junior from Dearborn. Blake Ezor, the tailback, 190 pounds, and they've got three good ones. Steve Montgomery's the fullback, the wideouts are Hawkins and Bradley. I'll give you the line in a moment. The ball resting at the 29-yard line. That was a pickup of 6 yards on the first carry, and I mean there was nothing fancy about it. Just put your head down and let it rip. Here goes Ezor, cutting it back off tackle, and he is going to be just a little short of his first down. The offensive front for Michigan State. It is Kula, Moten, Pearson, Keller, Johnson, and the tight end is Dwayne Young. Defensively for the Michigan Wolverines, down people are Brent White, Mike Teeter, and Chris Hutchinson. The backers are Marshall, Grant, Anderson, and Abrams, and the defensive secondary, Clayton, starts today. Todd played ahead of Dutton. Welburn and Murray are the safeties, and David Key is the other corner. And it is third down and a yard for Michigan State. Tailback carries it three straight times, and Ezor has the first down. The ball came out, however, and did he call it fumble? Alex Marshall is on it, and it's Michigan's ball. Alex Marshall recovers it for the Wolverines.
Whenever you have a big emotional game, turnovers will probably play a part in the ball game. This is an early fumble. Both teams can obviously recover from it, but the ball clearly out. Marshall, 59, picks it up. And it's a big turnover here early for Michigan.
Wolverines get the ball at the Michigan State 28. Mistakes will kill you. Eldis Gerback opens at quarterback as expected for Michigan. Michael Taylor is available. Gerback goes back trying to set it up. Big play on the first snap. Fires one down inside the 15 intended for McMurtry, and it is incomplete. The running backs behind Gerback are Tony Bowles, Leroy Horde had to move up to fullback when Jared Bunch got hurt. The wideouts are Chris Kellaway and Greg McMurtry. The offensive front for Michigan is huge. Doring 290, Dingman 290, Everett 280, Elliott 270, Skrepanak 340. The tight end is Derek Walker at 250. Second down and 10 for the Wolverines. Number 21, Desmond Howard, who is a freshman out of Cleveland, goes wide at the top of your picture. He is a speedster. I mean a burner. They run the ball with Bowles sliding to the right a little bit, getting in behind Skrepanak and Elliott, and he moves the ball down to about the 24-yard line. It is Vanderbeek, Reitinger, Davis, and Willerts up front for Michigan State, and they play a four-man front all the time. The backers are Edwards, the man in the middle, Percy Snow. They funnel everything to it. Carlos Jenkins is the strong side backer, and the secondary is Donaldson, Barnett, Aquinello, and Haller. Barnett is the key man, the strong safety in that defensive secondary. It is third down now for Michigan and six. Putting it up. Underneath. Intercepted. Look out. Picked off by Barnett. Right place, right time. And the 200-pound senior from Cincinnati picks up the Wolverine turnover.
Take a look up here now. The pattern is going to be run out here. He's going to try and make a completion. Look, he overthrows the receiver. Barnett always with good vision. His third interception, his second interception of the year. He has two fumble recovers. Take a look at the pass protection. Reitinger and Davis, 75 cross. Pretty good protection. A little problem in the pocket, but no problem for the quarterback. The ball just overthrown, and the turnovers are even at one.
If Callaway doesn't get him on the tackle in pursuit, he might have scored. So here's Michigan State now in that exchange of turnovers, gaining. They've snapped this from the 38. Here's Enos' first pass. The pass is complete to Montgomery, the fullback, swinging out of the backfield, and he picks up 7 yards up to the 45-yard line. Montgomery is a load. He's 240 pounds.
Montgomery was a walk-on 5 years ago. He's a fifth-year senior, just a walk-on. He's been a two-year starter. Now he's a tri-captain. It's a great story.
Ezor coming off shoulder injury, his first real injury-free action since the second game of the season. Blake has the ball, and he's a tough customer and close to the first down as he butts heads with J.J. Grant, the inside backer for Michigan. Well, let's see how they want to call it here as the referee, Ron Winter, has a look around. The umpire is Jim Augustine. Ed Peters, the head linesman. Don Bauer is the line judge. Michael Sheehan, the field judge. It is not a first down. It'll be third and one. Ken Baker, the side judge, and Mike Nevin is your back judge. Montgomery out. Highland Hickson is in. You got two tailbacks in there now. Hickson is a junior out of Fort Lauderdale. He's a 210-pound tailback. He's very strong, and he blows it up the middle and picks up the first down. So George Perlis puts a tailback into the fullback position, a big fella with great quickness, and he just blows a hole as he goes on up to the Michigan 45-46-yard line.
Perlis told us that one of the reasons that Hickson would be in at fullback is because that the fullbacks that he has aren't good runners. They're good blockers, good receivers. He knew that Michigan would key on the tailback and leave the fullback alone. He wanted to get another tailback in at fullback to get some production run-wise out of that position.
Montgomery comes back now. Ezor remains the tailback as Hixon leaves after that one carry, and Dan Enos rolls it out, comes back the other way, sets up a screen for Ezor, finds a crack. First down, Michigan State at the Michigan 26-yard line. Veda Murray brought him down.
Outstanding call. This is a great way to slow down the rush. He rolls to his left. It's a screen to the right the entire time. A nice, delicate, easy throw. Watch the block from 77. That's Bolton. 68 is Pearson. Outstanding play. Good running and good blocking.
Pearson, the senior who got out there to throw that block from his center position. He's a junior, actually. Transfer over from Notre Dame. Montgomery goes in motion now. Ezor has the ball, looks to the left side, and he is cut down on a diving tackle by Mike Dieter, number 91. George Perlis talking about what this game means. Yeah, George gets wound up on that subject.
Everybody knows this isn't George's program. This is a bridge program. I'm just fighting like heck trying to bridge back to Duffy and Biggie. If I can do that, I'm going to be a very happy man the rest of my life. And I think we have a chance to do that. It means so much to me. Yeah, I couldn't explain it without getting emotional.
Duffy being Duffy Doherty, Biggie being Biggie Munn. The previous coaches have a little whip to the sideline. The pass is caught. Second catch for Montgomery, the fullback. So Enos had number 95, J.J. Grant, coming right down the barrel and literally in his face and snapped that throw off and made it work. That shows me some gizzard, Bob.
It does. One of the things that Michigan likes to do inside the 20 is blitz their safety. Here's number 17, Williams, on a safety blitz. Michigan doesn't blitz a lot, but you get inside the 20 or the 25-yard line. It's a nice play by Enos to stay in the pocket, throw to the outside, and as you say, had a little guts on that one.
3 out of 3, 34 yards, third down and 2. Montgomery out, Hixon back in at the fullback position now. And Hixon has it. And that time he probably should have given it to the second man because Hixon had no place to go. Alex Marshall and Chris Hutchinson were there about the time he got the ball.
Tackled by 59, Alex Marshall. In for Michigan State, number 10, John Langlo.
Here's a look at the outside linebacker, Alex Marshall. Steps to his outside. The entire line was slanting that way, and that's one of the reasons it's so difficult to run against Michigan. They're always slanting one way or the other.
37-yard field goal try by John Langlo. Josh Butlin holds it. It is blocked. The Wolverines block it and return it. David Key, who is a defensive back, a quarterback, picked it up and hauled it back upfield.
Steve Fisher ought to check these guys out. Maybe he wants them on his basketball team. Tremendous leap. Watch the two men right behind the line of scrimmage. These men up front get penetration, and they're going to leap and get the block of the field goal. Outstanding effort.
I can't tell who got it.
Couldn't see it either.
But the special team folks are making a lot of noise this season around the country. Everywhere, every weekend, you look at a half a dozen instances where special teams, kicking teams, have done something heroic to win a ball game. Elvis Gerback gives the ball to Tony Bowles, and Bowles makes something happen for the Wolverines as Tony runs for a first down just short of the 50. That snap was from the 39, brought down by Ike Quinello, a junior from Dearborn. Bowles has been a little late getting the start. He had a big run last year. Got dinged up a little bit, and Hord stole his thunder at the Rose Bowl. Bunch got hurt. Hord goes to fullback, and now Michigan is still really trying to find the sequence, the combination.
The loss of the fullback, Bunch, he was 240. It really hurt that offense. Yep. He was a big, big, strong blocker.
Not having Dingman a healthy hurt him, too, I think.
Yeah.
Big guard. Penalty flag as Gerback throws, and he's lucky to get it back. I mean, the ball was thrown more directly to the defensive back Donaldson than it was to McMurtry.
Incomplete. Flag on the play. Donaldson
just overthrew the ball. He's 6'5". He's got a strong wind behind him, and sometimes that'll carry the ball further.
It's against Michigan with 8 minutes and 40 seconds to go. We keep swapping the ball around. We've had two turnovers. We've had a blocked kick. And so far, no scoring. The Buffaloes continue to make their point, don't they?
They are really good. I was really impressed.
Texas A&M shutting down the heralded run and shoot of Houston so far.
From the Wolverine 45.
That's a long day for you. If you can shut out Houston, you ought to call off the rest of the season. I don't know if anybody could shut those guys down. Might beat them, but I don't think
he's wide open. Wide open.
First down and 50. Tony Bowles. About three. That's Percy Snow, number 48. And if you want to entertain yourself some today, just kind of put your eyes on 48 in the green shirt.
Well, we'll be watching him throughout the ball game, and the key there, as you mentioned, is that Michigan State's defensive line tries to keep everybody, all the offensive linemen, away from him. The defensive line kind of give up themselves to hold off the offensive line so Percy can run from side to side making the play.
He's 245 pounds at 6'2", and when he hits you, it's a little like having a wall fall on you. He hits you. I mean, you know he's been there when he passes by. Penalty flags against Michigan.
Dead ball. Illegal procedure, Michigan.
Crowd's going to be well into the mid-70s. It's sold out and been sold out. And the crowd's pretty close to you here. They get into the ballgame. So that penalty moves the football back to the 44-yard line now.
Second down, 16.
Michigan getting their first conference win last week at home against Wisconsin. And Michigan State winning by 3 points on the road at Iowa. Next week, Michigan goes to Iowa. That's Callaway in motion. Gerbach turns and gives to Tony Bowles, and Bowles gets a good block from Horde. He got a dandy block on the corner, and he picks up a first down as Aquinella runs him out of bounds.
First down, Michigan.
Take a look at Percy Snow, number 48. Watch from the left of your screen. The tight end's going to come. That's Walker. That stops the penetration, allows the man to get through, and doesn't allow Percy Snow to get over. He's supposed to make that play. Tight end made the block on Snow.
Seal inside involving the fullback, but Dingman, the pulling guard, went outside and got the corner man and took him right out, just put him on his back. Having Dingman back is a big plus for Michigan. Bowles again runs it over the left side behind Dingman and Everett. And the gain is about 3 yards. Now let's join Roger Twyman in New York.
Tony Bowles.
Thank you very much, Keith. Story in Ames, Iowa today for third-ranked Colorado was a bad one. Great running back Eric Bieniemy fractured right tibia. He had scored 9 touchdowns coming into this game today. Colorado beats Iowa State 52-17. Out in Tucson, it's 102 degrees on the field. David Eldridge, 2 touchdowns as the Wildcats lead it. Let's go back to Keith.
At home, I'll tell you right now, they very well may win that ball game, and they might win it big. Gerbach rolls back, pulls it down, and keeps it. Looked like it was a planned to play at 6:55 to go, and he comes up short of the first down. Here's Jack Arruda.
Well, Keith, the star middle linebacker for Michigan State, Percy Snow, has already been warned by the officials for some late hits after the whistle. On that first series of downs with McMurtry, he put a knee to the side as he was getting back up, and they're watching him very carefully during this series.
27-yard line for Michigan. Third down and 2. Bowles close to it and should have it. Looks like he'll have it. Dixon Edwards, who is the weak side backer, in other words, he plays away from the tight end on the defenses. He shot through there and came within an eyelash of getting a big loss on that play.
Really did. He was in the backfield. As you see, Bo Schembechler calling the plays. His offensive coordinator, Gary Moeller, not with him on the sidelines. Moeller fell during the week and broke an ankle and an elbow, and is calling the plays along with Bo from the press box.
Ball is marked inside the 25-yard line. First down for Michigan. Tony Bowles, 6 carries and 44 yards so far. This time, Leroy Horde gets it. And Leroy is inside the 20, and he is down to about the 17-yard line. Talked yesterday to Percy Snow and asked him about the position he plays at the defensive alignment, and he said this.
He's right there in the middle of it all. I mean, that's where the game is played, in the middle of the defense. And I'm just crazy about it.
Senior from Kenton. He does play with abandon.
He loves to play it.
Six-man front up there. Snow dives inside, penetrating, but he guessed wrong. He picked the outside hole, and Horde, the fullback, went inside, trying to pick up the first down. He had to go to the 14 to get it, and he is close. They will measure at 5 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the first quarter of play.
Ball is inside the 15.
They got it.
First down, Michigan.
So Michigan blocking a field goal try by Michigan State's Langlow after a turnover by each team, and the Wolverines now have pounded the ball down to the 14-yard line.
And we've had confirmation it was Beta Murray that was up there and blocked a field goal.
Beta Murray, one more time. You realize how many big plays
big plays
he's made over the years? Wow, good play. Gerback gives it to Bowles. And Tony Bowles rolls it inside the 5. First and goal to go Wolverine.
Just good blocking up front. See 57, that's Dixon. He's blitzing. Nobody's blocking, but the play is going away from him. And just good tough running by Bowles to get it inside the 5.
You realize what's going on here?
They're running the football
that's
against
right.
Michigan State. And you know, Bo, he says, if I can't run for 200 yards, he says, I don't feel good, even if we win.
Bernie Leggett comes into the game now as Michigan loads up in the wishbone formation. They give it a Bowles, and he's at the goal line, but not in.
To look at it from behind the defense, 48 is Snow, 46 is Leggett. You can be assured that there's going to be a hat on Snow everywhere if they run that football today.
11th play in this possession coming up for the Michigan Wolverines. They're threatening to score on second down and goal. It is the up man. It is the dive over the top by Leggett, and he did not get there.
Well, Percy Snow says he loved to play it. He says it's what makes him go. Take a look at this now. Looking right down the goal line. Percy Snow's in the middle for 48. He's going to meet the ball carrier right at the top. Snow jumps and stops him right where he hits him.
That's Donaldson.
Donaldson?
Yeah, the man, the high man. Percy's on the bottom.
Okay.
But he had him locked.
And maybe he'll make Donaldson a middle linebacker.
Yeah.
He plays that position
got
pretty well.
Got the mentality for it, doesn't he? This is Jefferson. He will not score. Number 36, Harlan Barnett, made the play for Michigan State.
Well, they get in a wishbone look with 3 backs, and it just develops too slowly. You see 51, that's Jenkins, gets some penetration, but the other 2 backs don't get out of the way and get their blocks soon enough. Good defense on the part of the Spartans.
So it is 4th down and goal. The ball is a yard away. Leroy Horde has come back into the lineup. So it's Horde 33, Bowles 42. One of those has got to get this ball. It is Horde, and it's touchdown.
Oh.
side, see the surge of the offensive line. There's a little crease on the other side. Ford is the power runner of the running backs for Michigan. Now that bunches out of there.
Carlson for the extra point. Ken Solomon holds it. Steve Everett snaps it. It's good. 2 minutes, 40 seconds to go in the first quarter. Michigan sends a message. We can run the ball.
Winner of the Michigan-Michigan State game has gone on to win the Big Ten Conference title and appear in the Rose Bowl.
13 plays, 61 yards, all of it on the ground. They gobbled up 6.5 minutes. And I do believe, as I said, they sent a message. Seven to nothing, Wolverine. Hawkins is the deep man for Michigan State as Carlson squares around to kick it off. He should get good carry. The wind is blowing that way. About a 20-mile-an-hour wind out of the end zone. My goodness, he's 3 yards deep, and he's hustling out. And he pops it pretty good, too. He got it out to the 30-yard line. So Courtney Hawkins shows some quickness. And the Spartans have good field position for this possession. Brilliantly beautiful day. Autumn colors are just absolutely spectacular in Michigan right now. And the Wolverines leading by a score of 7-0. And Michigan State now coming up. Their first possession, it was 3 plays and a fumble. Their second possession, 7 plays and a blocked field goal. Let's see what happens now. Dan Enos sets him up. Blake Ezor is the tailback. They reverse it to Hawkins, and Hawkins is pinned in. Will pick up a couple of yards. Bobby Abrams smelled it and sought out the man. He got his quarry for a 2-yard pickup. Abrams, 6'3", 230, senior, Detroit. And he has just been absolutely spectacular this entire season.
He leads the Wolverines in tackles. He is a also leads them in sacks. He's got a brother, as a matter of fact, that is at Michigan State. The freshman credits his father with really a big influence on his life. And he has played outstandingly the last few weeks, as you mentioned.
Second down. Ball just short of the 31. Man in motion is Bradley. Enos rolls it out. Will pull it down and run with it. And number 95 picks him off. J.J. Grant, senior from Liverpool, New York.
Tackled by J.J. Grant. 95 Grant.
The enemy, the brilliant running back for Colorado, breaking a bone in his leg. That'll hurt him.
That'll be a big loss for him. He was an outstanding back.
It was.
But that's what football's all about. You want to test their depth.
Injury is part of the game.
Right.
Third and six. Marshall came loose. Number 59.
Enos tackled by Alex Marshall. 59 Marshall.
29 on the left side is Young. He's trying to block Marshall. He looks like he's expecting some help or something because he opens up the inside. Young wears number 29, but he's 256 pounds, so he's not a small man.
So that'll bring up the punt for Michigan State. Josh Butland bench presses over 400 pounds. He can hit a lick. Look at that thing.
Ooh.
That's up to the top of the stadium, forcing Trip Wilburn into a fair catch call back at the Michigan 26-yard line. He knocked that thing right into the wind, and he hit it up above the stadium. That young fella has got a leg. And then 16 seconds to go in the first quarter. Michigan Wolverines on the ball at their own 26-yard line, and they're leading by 7. Michigan State unable so far to generate any offense. Gerback remains your quarterback. Tony Bowles has got a big first quarter. And he's got about another 7 or 8 yards to add to his total. And he went out of bounds, stopping the clock with 11 seconds to go in the first period. Play is being sent in from the sidelines. Gary Moeller's upstairs, what with his broken bones.
He's voting on the play. It has to go through Bo. I wonder how many of them finally get to the player.
Ball is on the 34. It was an 8-yard pickup. 2 yards on second down for Michigan. Leroy Horn, the fullback, to the 40 and a first down.
Wolverine ball carrier, Leroy Horn.
Again, they stopped the clock to move the chains. Now the referee will wind it.
Number 51, Jenkins.
As soon as the chains are down, then Michigan can run one more play.
What Michigan is doing is a little misdirection in the backfield that's holding
Michigan
Percy Snow, the middle linebacker, to allow one of the offensive linemen at least a chance to get to him.
Bo said they couldn't
Michigan
sit out here and butt heads
seven.
With him. That's the end of the first quarter. So after one, Michigan leading Michigan State 7-0. Leading Michigan State 7-0. Here we go to the second quarter of play. Michigan owns the lead 7-0, and they own the football. First down at their own 40-yard line, and Alan Jefferson is in the backfield now for Michigan. And Leroy Horde carries for the Wolverines, and a typical Horde run, breaking a tackle at the line of scrimmage and ripping it across midfield for a first down. We told you a couple of times about Gary Moeller and his physical problems. He fell off a little platform, broke his elbow, and broke his ankle, and this is how he got aboard the bus this morning. You talk about an unhappy camper.
That's tough duty there. I mean, how do you break two things on a fall? Usually, if you have bad luck, you break one.
Well, as soon as he gets well, he'll be forever today needled by this group of Wolverines, won't he? From the 48-yard line, on first down, this is Tony Bowles, and Michigan continues to blow Michigan State off the ball, and they have neutralized Percy Snow so far.
And they're doing it with just big size. Their big offensive linemen up front are straight blocking some of the time and just creating a bunch of holes. Interesting first quarter stat is the run yardage for Michigan. 88 yards in the first quarter alone is the story of that first quarter.
Second down for the Wolverines. 4. Ball on the Michigan State 43. And Tony Bowles near the 40. Travis Davis, who is their leading defensive tackler along the down lineman, made that stop, but there's a battle going on inside. The Michigan center, Steve Everett, 51. And his main target would be Percy Snow, 48. And look what I found, said Steve.
Well, he does a nice job, does Everett, in getting to him. The play was not designed to go back inside. It was supposed to be a little wider, but other defensive players turned it back into Snow.
Center normally will look for the middle linebacker, and that time Steve found him. And on the try for the first down, good offensive line surge by Michigan. Carrying the ball is Tony Bowles, and it appears he will have his first down.
What short yardage, and they're running right at Percy Snow. Here's Snow right here. It's going to be straight blocking. The fullback is going to go right for Snow. He's going to step up in the pocket, not in the pocket, but in the hole that's created, and try to do some damage. Horde, 33. Bowles sees the little hole to the right side and picks up the first down. Straight blocking, straight at him.
Putting the ball at the Michigan State 38. Szymanski is in there at a defensive end position now for Michigan State. Boy, there isn't anything working on that one, was there? Ford had the ball. Travis Davis had him. Give you an idea of the size difference now. Szymanski is 270. He and Davis are the two big people in the down position defensively for Michigan State. Reitinger is at 245 and Willard's at 250. Whereas Michigan's offensive front from tackle to tackle goes 290, 290, 280, 270, 340.
That averages 292 for Michigan's offensive line, and Michigan State's defensive line is 255. That's 37 pounds per man.
Second down and nine. Gerbach sets up the screen, throws it to Horde, looks for a block, gets one from Everett, and gets across the 30 to the 29-yard line. Talking yesterday with Steve Everett about getting a piece of Percy Snow, and this is what he had to say about what he was going to try to do.
We've got to be smart. We got to move our feet. And, you know, he'd much rather take on a running back than an offensive lineman, so if we get in his face, and hopefully we can keep him out. Because if we can block him, then secondary's got to make the tackles. And if the secondary starts making tackles, you know, we gain 7 or 8 yards of play.
The secondary starts making tackles, you are on your way to a win.
Yes, sir.
Third down and two. Bowles. No, sir. He didn't get there, I don't believe. Don't think he got there.
Bowles carried Tony Bowles.
Everett is an art major. He says, I live in two different worlds. Says, I sit back with a piece of charcoal, draw nudes, and then go across campus and get my head beat in. But Bo was impressed with this young man last spring.
Ball at the 29.
He learned to snap left-handed after mashing several fingers of his right hand. Bo says he's going to be a great one.
Number 38, J.D. Carlson.
Into the wind, we're about to see a 46-yard field goal try by J.D. Carlson. Solomon's going to hold it. And on fourth down and two, they decide to go for three. Michigan State got caught in the neutral zone. The kick is way off the mark, but I think Michigan State is offside. It'll be first down, Michigan.
That's just inexcusable. Perlis has got to be upset. That's like a turnover. You got the ball, and now you're going to give it back to Michigan.
The left end, defensive left end.
Well, the chances of that guy, Carlson, making the field goal into the wind is not very good. Offsides. The microphone is not working. Look at the bottom of your screen. It's the end man on the line trying to block a field goal that's going to be 47 yards into the wind. He's going to make that one anyway.
Nope. So a mistake. Another mistake in the game. First down for Michigan. Call it the 24 of Michigan State, and Gerbach back. He looks. He throws underneath the Horde. Good move by Leroy. Gets in close to the 15-yard line. About 9 yards. He had McMurtry drifting on a post, but the Spartans really didn't bite on it, and Horde made look at that. Texas jumping all over Oklahoma. 21-7. Ooh-wee. Well, this week the Hokies got whacked.
Bobby Ballinger's got him heading in the right direction, doesn't he?
Yeah. I got all marble mouth last week. I was trying to say the Hokies' win over West Virginia last week may have reminded you of the days when they were known as Gobblers and Dooley was there. Frank Beamer's team pulling off a big, huge win last week. This is Bowles outside. Good pursuit by Barnett. So Harlan Barnett in pursuit. The senior from Cincinnati gets another tackle. It's been all Michigan so far.
It has, and Michigan had the win in the first quarter. Michigan State has not had a possession with that win to do anything with it. They had one, but they didn't do anything. It's the wind was blowing pretty good when the game started. It seems to have died down just a tad.
McMurtry brought the play. Double wide, bottom of the screen. McMurtry and Callaway. You're back. Looking for one of them down the middle. Tipped in the air and incomplete. You want to know something? He's going to go back and look at the pictures on that one and kick himself because he could have had either man if he'd have touched the ball.
Well, he didn't see the middle linebacker. Snow is right here. He's going to drop right back in. The defensive line is going to do a little game, a little twist inside. The protection will be good. Gerbach looking into the sun. Look at the shadows on the field. Doesn't see Snow at all.
He put some air into that thing, though. He had the touchdown. 35-yard field goal try now. As Carlson gets it up, and good. And he is now 8 for 8. So J.D. Carlson having a dream season so far. 8 for 8 at field goals, and Michigan goes out to a 10-0 lead at 9:16 to play in the first half. The ball is put down. Courtney Hawkins now. Courtney is standing up past the 5. And he should be, because Carlson now has got to kick the ball into this wind. Well, he nailed it. He runs him back to the 3, bobbles it around at the 3, and here he comes looking for some help in the middle. And he's out to the 20, and that'll just about do it. And the ball might have been rolling around the way people were piling on there, but they're going to call him down. At 9:08 to go, Michigan State now finally gets the ball with the wind at their back. Stadium. Michigan State led Michigan 14-3, fourth quarter. Demetrius Brown passed 18 yards to Jamie Morris, made it 14-9, converted 2 points, 14-11. Then, after a Spartan field goal, the Wolverines started moving again, but Todd Crum picked off a Michigan pass to lock the door. It was the 7th Spartan interception. Michigan State won 17-11 and went on to win the Rose Bowl. Michigan State now coming up with the wind at their back and will move the ball from the 23. First down, Michigan leading 10-0 in the first half. Enos gives to Ezor. Ezor gets a hole left side and will get it up to about the 26, close to the 27. Tonight, as the world knows, the World Series begins. And in case you don't know, it's here on ABC Sports. The Bay Area Series between the American League champions Oakland and National League champion San Francisco. And it all gets going at 8 o'clock here on ABC.
Who do you like, Keith?
I'm not going to tell you.
Well, I like San Francisco. I'll tell you, I like San Francisco.
I think Oakland's the best team in baseball. Ezor to the 30. But that does not necessarily mean they will win in 7. But I would have, if I'm going to be backed up against the wall and pick a team, I would have to pick an Oakland. There's one of the reasons reflected right there, Bob Greasy, why the Michigan State Spartans aren't running up and down the field.
Exactly right. Michigan and Lloyd Carr, defensive coordinator, does an outstanding job. He's been there for several years. Michigan has always been right one or two in defense in the Big Ten. It's because of Lloyd Carr.
Here goes Ezor again. And when he made his plant and cut, he was looking for the marker, and I don't think he got there, and here's Jackaroot.
Keith, you'd think at 10-0 that the Michigan State defense would be plumb tuckered out. Well, that's not really the case. Percy Snow and the linemen came down here to the line, to the bench. They met with their defensive coach. They've made a couple of adjustments. Snow wiped it off, had a little bit of sweat, but then he got back up and got to the front of the line, chomping at the bit to get back in and try and stop this ongoing slot by Michigan.
Well, Percy gets all the headlines, but ain't going to do it alone. Not against a team like Michigan. They did get the first down by a whisker. Ezor is deceptive. Blake weighs 190 pounds, and when he plants and cuts, he does it with some real velocity, and it was that produced the first down. And Dan Enos is back to throw. Underneath it goes. Pass is caught by Ezor out of the backfield, and it's a first down for Michigan State. And suddenly, here's a little spark for them as they pick up another first down.
This is one of the things that Enos and Michigan State need to do. Forget about running on first down. Throw some little screens, a little check down here by Enos. It's just like a running play with a long handoff. Get it to your speed back and let him take the ball upfield.
And it's 4-for-4 now in his passing for 46 yards. So that obviously tells you it's available. On first down, it's Ezor across midfield. Penalty flag goes down. The ball goes to the Michigan 48.
Blake Ezor carry.
That's a 7-yard pickup, and let's see about the flag.
Joel Abram, along with Anderson, made the tackle. There is a flag.
Eric Anderson signals to his side of the field that it's against Michigan State. The Spartans have dropped all the way back inside their own 45, so it must be. Probably holding. No procedure. Somebody got
illegal procedure, Michigan State.
Somebody moving.
5-yard penalty.
Here's a look at Lloyd Carr, defensive coordinator for the Wolverines, who has done just an outstanding job year after year. Michigan, we mentioned, leading the Big Ten in total defense, pass defense. Only one rushing touchdown has been scored against Michigan the first four games of the year.
First and 15 from the 40.
I presume somebody will try to fix his microphone at halftime.
You always see Bo yelling and screaming and trying to exhort his troops on. Sometimes he just mild-mannered and just content.
You got a timeout. The referee has come off the field right now. Ron Winter has come over to the sideline. And believe it or not, he is talking on the phone. Now, you don't have a replay in college football.
Official timeout to reset the clock. Take off 7 seconds.
And what he wanted to do was come over and tell the folks to take 7 seconds off the clock. And since he doesn't have a working microphone at his belt, he had to come over and pick up the phone. Well, we're getting old-fashioned. It's an old-fashioned football game. We'll get rid of all these fancy gimmicks and get on back down to button heads and having some fun.
Here's some scores. Minnesota 14, Northwestern 10, third quarter. Fourth quarter, Ohio State 35, Indiana 21.
Third Ohio quarter, State Illinois out to 7, a big lead over Indiana in a key
third
Big
quarter,
Ten game.
Iowa 24.
35-21 in the second half of play, Ohio State. Buckeyes have been a severe up and down. They go from high to low to high to low. So there's the action going on in the Big Ten today. And it's the final, 35-31. 35-31. And Minnesota trying to win one today. And Iowa hands full with Wisconsin. So it looks like the Badgers, after that very poor outing against Miami, kind of their neck bowed a little, aren't they?
Played very, very well against Michigan last week. Bo was so angry that he didn't let any of his players talk to the media this week.
This is Ezor trying to get outside, and they're having nothing to do with it, and it's Alex Marshall one more time. So Alex is having a big, big day.
Ezor, the ball carrier, tackled by Alex Marshall, 59 Marshall.
You know, last year, about this time, maybe a little bit later after the season, Bo was over in Indiana recruiting a quarterback, and they were watching the Monday night game with Deardorff comes on Monday night, says, oh great, it's a Michigan man. He says, I'm trying to sell this young quarterback on Michigan. It's great. Then he found out that it was the Chicago Bears with Jim Harbaugh at quarterback. I'll get back to it in a minute.
Enos the throw goes underneath, and the pounding hooves of Alex Marshall had something to do with the fact that Blake Ezor didn't catch that ball.
Incomplete. Intended for Ezor. Marshall on the play for Michigan.
So Schembechler is sitting in this recruit's home, and two Michigan men are on TV. Deardorff doing the broadcast, and Jim Harbaugh, the quarterback. And the first words out of Deardorff's mouth is, of 16,000 passes thrown annually in the National Football League, a Michigan quarterback has never thrown a touchdown pass in the National Football League. Bo sits there stunned for a minute, turns to the kids and says, yeah, and I want you to be the first one. That kid went to Notre Dame, Rick Meyer.
And he's going to be a great
one. He is.
Making the catch is James Bradley, a junior out of Orval, Ohio. He's a junior college transfer. And he is anywhere near first down territory, so Michigan State's punting team has got to come in now. So that one little procedure call against them hurts them, and they can't pick up another first down after they got two, and now they got to punt it away, so they continue to make mistakes. Expensive mistakes. 47 yards for Butlin on the first one. The wind's at his back this time. If he gets it, he may go out of the stadium. I mean, folks, that is that's a Division 1A punt right there. You want to talk about it? Out of bounds in the Coffin Corner at the 4-yard line. 52 yards, no return. Sign him up. I would say they have an heir to the legacy of Mr. Montgomery.
Perennial power Iowa or UCLA hits the Oregon Trail to take on Oregon State next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
That's halftime with Roger Twibel. I don't know who's doing the Antarctica. Hey, Roger, you want to go to Antarctica? Pack your mucklucks. I don't wish to go this time of year. I tell you, it's been the most exhilarating weekend for color, for flavor, for everything that is involved in the ambiance of a college football game. We have had it here in East Lansing, Michigan this weekend. Just been an absolute pleasure.
Just walking across campus was brings back a lot of memories.
Ball is inside the five at the four, where it's first down for Michigan. Gerbach has gone all the way at quarterback, gives the ball to Tony Bowles, and Tony rustles his way for 5 yards up to about the nine, and it'll be second down and close to five. Here's Jackaroot.
Keith, you know the fact that Gary Moeller's upstairs and not calling the offensive plays down here on the sidelines. He has to go through Bo. Well, during that last timeout, Bo had to try and explain to his team the next two plays. They were all trying to get the translation. He finally said, shut up, guys, and I'll tell you what I need you to play next time.
We might as well get to the point. Ain't no sense in wasting breath. Bernie Leggett is in there at the blocking back position right now, or fullback for Michigan, on second down and five. And here comes Tony again across the 10 out near the 11. And Travis Davis brings him down. You've got right at 5 minutes now to go in the first half of play. The Michigan Wolverines have been the dominant team in this first half. Your Honda Scholar Athlete of the Week, brought to you by American Honda, supporting amateur athletics. This week's award goes to Rob Myers, senior punter from Washington State University, averaging better than 45 yards a punt, second best of the nation. Honda will present a check for $2,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of Washington State University. Myers major history, 3-1, grade point. That pleases me. That's my alma mater. We need all the help we can get. Third down and three. Gerbach. And he gives it to Bowles, and Bowles got away and gets the first down. Travis Davis had him, and Travis couldn't hold him, and Bowles goes and gets the first down the hard way.
First down, Michigan.
There's Travis Davis right here. Now, he's cocked in that cock position, much like Joe Green. He's going to come free. He just didn't make the tackle. Wearing number 75 is idle Joe Green, the Pittsburgh Steeler guy. Gets around him with some quickness, just does not bring Bowles down. Bowles is a sprinter, and this is where he can beat you to the sideline. Makes a good play and is going to pick up a first down.
You know, that Barnett is a tough customer back there, and he might have been the last bastion defensively for Michigan State. On first down, the Wolverines pounded up the middle, and Leggett gets a call. Leggett is a freshman from Colorado Springs, Colorado. What do you think about the Rams, Bob?
Well, there's a Purdue quarterback playing there. He's awfully good. They're 5-0. You know, you can't do much better, but I think they're going to have their hands full up in Buffalo.
Yeah, they really haven't gone into a snake pit yet.
Even though Buffalo is without Kelly, Buffalo's defense is really outstanding.
Rams are pretty good, though. I tell you, they're doing the basics very, very well right now. Second down and seven. This is Horde. And a whole lot of whoa right there at the 20. Led by Dixon Edwards, and this time Travis Davis was looking right at his man, and he wasn't about to turn him loose. Bowles is getting the play from Bo, and Tony brings it in.
Third and seven from the 20.
So the thing you don't want to do here if you're Michigan is turn the ball over, make a silly mistake. Third and seven, and you've got 3 minutes to go in the half. You're against the wind. Just don't make any mistakes.
What Michigan has done in the first half is dominate with the run. That's going to force Michigan State into some gambling. There's pass is thrown away by Gerbach. Gerbach had 40, Reitinger, and Szymanski or Willerts? I guess it's Willerts, wasn't it? Yeah, Chris Willerts. Both of them about to pound him right down in the ground.
One of the things that State does so well, Reitinger is here. He's going to come in here. Davis is going to crisscross. Willerts is out here. This is putting pressure on the quarterback with a little line twist. Picks up the blocking assignments. It's tough to stay with your man. One of the problems you have when you try to throw the football.
Chris Stapleton is in the punt now, and Michigan State should get this ball with pretty good field position. Just under 3 minutes to go. The last point scored in the first half oftentimes means so much in a game. This is a low line drive that Hawkins bobbles, and that cost Michigan State probably 5, maybe even 10 yards on the return. He had a chance to put it down around the Michigan 45 and just simply didn't handle the ball. So far, the Michigan State Spartans have only themselves to blame, trailing 10 to nothing. Statistics basically the litany on Michigan State so far. They fumbled on the opening drive. They had a field goal blocked. There was a key penalty that gave Michigan a first down that led to the field goal for them. They had a penalty that cost them a first down in possession. They just dropped the punt, costing good return posture. And here's Dan Enos trying to run a bootleg, and all he does is run into a blitzing strong safety Trip Welborn and loses a half a dozen yards.
One of the things Lloyd Carr does, here he has a strong safety. Wilburn is going to blitz up here. Zone in the secondary, but he gets a little pressure from the outside by sending someone that you can't block. Enos doesn't seem, and it's a big play again starting off for Michigan.
Bobby Abrams is out now, and a nickelback is in for Michigan in the secondary. Number 17, Otis Williams, is in there as a fifth defensive back. So they're expecting Michigan State to go to the air now, and Enos does not. He gives it away to his tailback, and he gets planted by Mike Teeter. Mike came in and got a hold of Blake Ezor's hind leg, and he just lucked it.
One of the criticisms of George Perlis has been that he's too conservative offensively. Is a draw play kind of a stutter draw or a slant draw, roll draw?
Whatever, it didn't work, did it?
Didn't work at all. Third and 15.
Enos has some time, and it is intercepted. A great interception by J.J. Grant. At a minute and 16 seconds to play, Michigan has the ball down around the Michigan State 45.
Well, just what Michigan State and Perlis didn't want, an opportunity for Michigan to score. Receiver's going to run a square in. Here's Grant here, faking the blitz, going to get back and actually make the interception in the middle of the field.
I mean, this is, look at this. It tip it a little bit, soft hands.
Nice play.
And so the Wolverines move it 15 yards. They got a chance to tack on some more.
Starting line is the Breslin Center, and runners begin.
Here's that last interception. 95 was up faking the blitz. Enos is downwind and down sun. No problem looking down that way. He just thought he could get it over J.J. Grant's hands. Grant coming up with his first interception of the year.
Call it the 46 now, and first down, Michigan Wolverines. They lead 10 to nothing at a minute and 16 seconds, and they're going to run a reverse. Here comes Callaway. Callaway gets a block on the corner, but it was a slow-developing sort of a thing, and Michigan State had time to recoil and come across and pick him up at the 39. So they get 7 yards on the play, and the clock is stopped with a timeout at 1:02. Michigan calling it. They have two remaining.
Buffalo to meet the Bills.
Oh, my
on ABC's Monday Night Football.
All right, during the timeout, Michigan plotting its next series of plays because the ball is resting now at the Michigan State 39. You got a minute and 2 seconds to go. They got two timeouts remaining. They lead 10 to nothing, and they want to get Carlson close enough to pick up another three if they can't get six.
McMurtry can pass. Now, they may throw the ball out there and have him throw it.
If you got a gimmick play, this is a pretty good time for it.
Right.
Here's your screen, goes to Hoard. Hoard has Dingman out in front of him. Dingman lays the block, and Hoard's got a big one. Down to the Michigan State 18-yard line.
Pass complete to Hoard. Mike Winella and Jenkins on the play for State. There's a flag.
There's a flag back up field. It's holding Michigan. Forget it. Won't count. Ball's coming back. Pretty play, though. That pulling guard Dingman got out there and he decked.
It was a well-designed play.
Guy.
Obviously, both not too happy. He's talking to the umpire, somebody in the middle of the field, one of the officials that doesn't agree with it.
I think that the next couple of plays here, I think if Michigan's going to get at least a field goal.
53 yards.
He really wanted that play.
Michigan, 10-yard penalty.
However, a field goal out of this drive.
53 seconds to go. And score out west. Arizona has gone ahead of UCLA 28 to nothing in the second quarter.
Second down, 11.
Don't write those Wildcats off for that Pac-10 title. I'm telling you. They got something like 7 or 8 home games this year. Second down and 12. Gerbach. That's a busted play. Elvis runs out of bounds and kills the clock. He got out about midfield, so that was obviously screwed up from the snap. Here's Jack.
Heath, probably everybody thought that by now we would have seen the senior quarterback, Michael Taylor, at least take a few snaps because of his running prowess. He's healthy again, but Gerbach has done such a terrific job mixing the run and the play that the man that has been no more than 7 feet away at any time from head coach Bo Schembechler is Michael Taylor. He's very clean and just waiting for a chance.
He probably won't play him unless he feels there's some reason to. He might season him a little bit in the fourth quarter if he's got the game in hand.
I think if you put him in now, you shake the confidence of Gerbach.
Yep. Midfield. Third and very long now. They've got to go way down yonder to get themselves the first down. There's pursuit on Gerbach, but he buys time. His pass is away. The pass is caught by Derek Walker, the tight end. And now they wave it off. But he did not catch it cleanly. He does not agree.
What happened? Gerbach outside the pocket. Walker did a nice job of coming across field. I don't know. That's close. I'd have to say that's no catch because when he went to catch it the second time, I think the ground helped him hold on to it.
So J.J. Grant's interception is wasted. And the holding call wiped out opportunity for the Wolverines, and now Stapleton is in to punt. First one was only 32 yards. Pressure on him, but he gets it away. Kicks a low line drive, but he kicks it away from the Michigan State return man. And Hawkins, finally catching it on the bounce, runs it out of bounds and kills the clock with 16 seconds to go back at the 16-yard line. 42-yard punt that time with an 8-yard return. I tell you what, those low-line drive punts will get you in trouble if you're not careful.
Well, if you kick a low-line drive, you better kick it away from the punt returner or the kick returner and try to kick it out of bounds, which he did.
Only 16 ticks remaining on the clock. Three timeouts for Michigan State. They have done very little so far offensively in this first half against the top-ranked Michigan defense in the Big Ten. Veda Murray is back playing center field, way back at midfield. On the snap from the 16, Blake Ezor runs it. And the crowd hoots a little bit at a running play to close out the first half. And so they go to the clubhouse with the Michigan Wolverines leading at halftime over Michigan State by a score of 10 to nothing. Now let's join Roger Twibel at our studios in New York for our halftime activities. State.
Well, you're right. On the screen, the fumble, the opening drive.
State.
Well, you're right. On the screen, the fumble, the opening drive. Then they have a field goal block. Then they got the ball back, but two penalties kept the ball in possession of Michigan. They dropped the punt return and then the final interception. The Spartans have really not played well. Michigan defensively has really set the tone for the game, and offensively, their offensive line has really done it offensively for the Wolverines.
And so we're ready to go with the second half kickoff. Michigan will get the football. John Langlo will do the kicking. Tony Bowles and Desmond Howard will be the deep people for the Wolverines. Michigan in the white shirts. And it's 21 Howard on the left and 42 Bowles on the right. The wind swirling around down in the bottom of the big bowl here, so they've got to go back and put the ball on the tee, and somebody's going to come up and hold it for Langlo to hit it. And it's going to be entertaining, I think, to see what George Perlis and his folks have decided to try to do in the second half.
Well, you can bet as you take a look at the wind at the top of the stadium, it's blowing just about as hard at the floor, that Perlis was very emotional, and there were some choice words in that locker room.
The kick with the wind at his back is a high hanger to the goal line for Desmond Howard, the freshman from Cleveland, and that's pretty good coverage by Michigan State, but it's a result of the wind and the hanger, and here is Jackaroo.
Keith, in 1978, Michigan State beat Michigan by a score of 24-15, and this man accounted for a lot of it. Kirk Gibson, 10 years later, he did very well in the World Series, too. Kirk, not a good day today for your team.
Not so far, but they played, poorly right up to this point, but they're still in the game, and if they get it together, there's an opportunity to come back.
You were in the locker room. What did George Perlis say to the team?
I can't give that away, but George is a good coach. He's very professional, and he's a motivator. And that's not up to George. It's up to the guys to go do what got him so far.
Keith?
Air was purple. That's what it was. Just over the 15 for Michigan as Callaway goes in motion, and Gerback gives to Leroy Horde, and Leroy finds a hole and comes out to the 25. He is a half a yard short of the first down before Aquinella brings him down.
Leroy Horde carries.
First half statistics, 130 yards rushing for Michigan, jumps right out at you. Michigan State only 69 yards in total offense, and of course the two turnovers which we alluded to.
That 78 game they were talking about, I did that game. I remember Gibby took a little swing pass, played wide receiver.
Yeah.
Tore it up, went all the way. He was most people don't know, but that man was a tremendous outside receiver, wide receiver. Leroy Horde runs for the first down, 220-pound junior from New Orleans, and he just kept on pounding, bouncing off people, and he made it a big play.
Gerback has completed only three passes, one interception, and all of those three went to Horde. Horde gaining 30 yards rushing, Bowles with 87. Eno's not playing that poorly, only throwing seven times. Ezor with only 21 yards, and you got to get more production out of the running backs for Michigan State.
First down Wolverines now. Ball up near the 34. Gerback to Horde. Illinois got by Purdue 17-2, 35-31 for Ohio State. Minnesota won by two, and Iowa was in a tie with Wisconsin very late in the ball game and pulled it out 31-24. Michigan goes to Iowa next week. And the Michigan State Spartans next week will be hosting Illinois here. It won't be a picnic. Big sack all the way back at the 23-yard line by Travis Davis.
Watch the left guard pull. That's Digman 78, and right over him was lined up Davis. Davis just shoots the gap and gets in and makes the sack.
Davis, career-wise, is third in career sacks for Michigan State, second in career tackles for losses, and an outstanding defensive lineman for Michigan State.
There's your correct score on Illinois-Purdue. They had it wrong. Third down and long. Gerback getting a ton of time and finally runs, and he is hit almost out of bounds. You can see Gerback saying, hey, Jenkins got me out. But the referee, Ron Winter, shook his head, and there will be no penalty.
It's fourth down, Michigan. Ball on the 35.
No. He didn't put his shoulder into him and drive him. If he had, he'd have probably been flagged for it, but he didn't. Chris Stapleton comes in to punt, and Courtney Hawkins goes back to receive it. 32 and 42 on the two kicks by Stapleton today. He's punting into the wind. That's a high snap. Almost blocked. If 20 goes after that ball with a little more determination, he might very well have blocked it. In fact, I kind of thought that he should have. Todd Murray was right in his face and only put up one arm. But number 20 right there, Murray really had a chance to block that thing.
Middle of your screen was not a block situation. It was just a make sure they don't run the ball, and he could have got it if he would have gone after it.
Well, 27 to go in the third quarter now, and here is Michigan State with good field position. By the receiving team. Happened a couple of weeks ago, USC at Washington State. Used to be the kicking team could recover a free kick for a touchdown. Not anymore in the college game. Pro yes, college no. The football is at the 43-yard line of Michigan State. Spartans own the ball, and now is a very good time for them, I think, to do something offensively if they're going to get back into this ball game. Because in the fourth quarter, they're going to be working into the wind. Michigan is going to have the wind at their back. So this is a very good period for Michigan State to do something offensively. And I think it's become very clear they got to do this. They got to throw it. And that one is incomplete. It is intended for Bradley, and it was thrown into a crowd. Now here's Jack Arute.
Well, Keith, Kirk Gibson wouldn't tell us what was said in the locker room, but we have found out that George Perlis made up 2 points. He said, first, gentlemen, we've got to open up and play a little wider. Second of all, we've got to get doubly physical. We weren't physical enough in this first half. If we intend to win this game, we're going to have to double our efforts in the second half.
Well, he opened up on the first play, and I think he's right. He has to throw the ball, maybe some short passing, not necessarily down the field so far.
Right here. But by the time the play evolves, Chris Hutchinson is in the backfield and makes a tackle for a loss back to the 40-yard line. So those wideouts, I got a feeling the wideouts just aren't doing much. Now, I haven't been able to watch a whole lot of work by the wideouts, but I know the pass that was thrown to Bradley, there were three white shirts around it.
Yeah, that was a poor throw. It was designed to go to another receiver, and he was covered, and Enos just came off to him and threw it. That last play was a screen. Kula just needed to stay with his his defensive lineman a little longer.
And the wideouts have one catch so far today. There you go. Brent White ate him up.
This is just inexperienced at quarterback. Enos playing this year for the first time. He's going to have plenty of time to throw, and he's going to have some room in the pocket to slide to his right side, our left. The sack's going to come from the right. He needs to move around a little bit. Kula needs to stay with his man. That's the second time in a row that his man made the play.
Josh Butland hangs it way up there for Trip Welburn at the 14-yard line. Gets a little hole, comes back to the 25. That's a pretty good return by Trip Welburn. A 51-yard punt, 11-yard return, 10:55 to go. Third quarter, and Michigan is still dominating the game.
The Buffalo to take on the Bills as we continue the 20th anniversary season of ABC's Monday Night Football.
Kelly information booth under section 7.
26-yard line for the Michigan Wolverines. They lead in the ball game 10-0. And here they come again with the ball. And so far, it's been Gerback at quarterback all the way, even though the point was made early on that Michael Taylor was available, but Michigan has not needed the option offense. So they'll probably go on through the day. Might give him a few plays just to get his feet wet because they're going down to Iowa next week, and there they might need the option. This is Leroy Horde. And I mean to tell you, there was a couple of licks as Horde dropped his shoulder, and Tim Reitinger and Jim Szymanski were right there, and it was a full crunch. That's the lineup for next week here on ABC Sports. 3:30 Eastern. Check your local listing for the game in your area.
Second and 10 from the 26.
UCLA getting kicked sideways at Arizona today. From the 26. Davis made a move to the inside, and they set up the screen pass. That's a good catch by Horde. Horde's got a good gain out of it. Leroy Horde. There's a penalty flag upfield, and you're going to get a little extracurricular activity. Penalty here. A couple of them got tangled up upfield, and they did it right in front of the side judge or the back judge, and it was a whackety whack, and probably the retaliator got dinged.
Dead ball foul. Personal foul.
Personal foul is against the Wolverines. Derek Alexander, number 40, was the Michigander, the Michigan man who was down there, and the Michigan Stater was sort of looking at him.
First down, Michigan on the play.
It'll be first down and 25 now as they mark off the 15-yard penalty.
The first series or the second series in the second half, you usually find out what adjustments went on at halftime. Michigan not able to run on that first series against the state defense. Throws a screen pass, and it worked very well.
Ball comes back to the 23.
George Perlis had talked to Gene Calhoun, the head of the officials for the Big Ten, during the week, complaining about some of the late hits by the Michigan wide receivers.
First and 25.
I call that lobbying.
Yeah.
On first down, Gerback gives to Tony Bowles, and Bowles is taken down. Number 99, Willard, took him down, but it was Szymanski that slowed him down and set him up. Big Jim is from Sterling Heights at 270, and Chris Willard is at 250 from Bay City.
Ball on the 22, second and 26.
Just under 10 minutes to go now in the third quarter. Been pretty much all Michigan so far, but it's only 10-0. Gerback makes some weight. Michigan offensive front handles the defensive pressure, and he hits McMurtry right on the number, and it's first down or close to it. Very close.
Nice pass by Gerbach, just a slant pattern by McMurtry.
He'll be back to the original line of scrimmage, I should say, and not first down.
Yeah. McMurtry, an outstanding athlete, senior, wearing the number that Anthony Carter wore when he was at Michigan, number one. Bo says he is the salt of the earth. He's a good kid.
He may still wind up doing some baseball.
Yeah.
Depends on what happens in the football draft, I expect. Davis is after Gerbach, but he gets rid of the ball nicely. Drills the pass to Callaway up at the 46. But that is not going to be a first down. It'll be fourth down and 2.5.
They won't pick up the first down, but they do pick up about 20 yards, valuable yards, to allow the punter to move the ball further down the field. Michigan State needs to do something when they have the win at their back in this quarter, Keith.
They do. Stapleton, number 18, will do the punting. Hawkins will accept it for Michigan State. Last time it was a high snap. This time it's a good one. Low spinning kick and a pretty good kick, and it forces a fair catch call by Hawkins at the 21. 34-yard punt, no return. Timeout.
Colors on the campus and around the countryside here today. Stadium is a stadium is a stadium. So when you walk outside and cross the Red Cedar River onto the campus, it's just absolutely stunning.
First down, Michigan State at the 21.
7.5 minutes to go in the third quarter now, and Michigan State still trying to get something going. Go to the tailback, Ezor, and he'll have about 4 yards, and here's Jackaroo.
Keith, I'm with Steve Fisher, who was the interim head coach at the University of Michigan when you won the national championship. Now you're the new head coach. Tomorrow is the official start of practice for the NCAA. Can you make it two in a row for national champs?
We're not talking two in a row. We're talking about making it through the first week of practice, although we're going to have a good basketball team, as I think everybody knows.
Well, he got to watch his athletic director here do likewise as his athletic director did to him back in the Final Four. He's watching Bo Schembechler today.
Here's a little pitch to Ezor. Turns it upfield to the 30-yard line. And he is a yard short of the first down.
Ezor is a free spirit. Perlis really likes him. In fact, his dad called George Perlis. His dad was living in Las Vegas, was a pit boss out there. One of the casinos had met Perlis earlier and was trying to sell Blake to Perlis. Perlis said, yeah. Another father trying to sell his son. Turns out he was an All-American. Notre Dame wanted him. Penn State wanted him. Kamen is an outstanding running back.
He got his first down, but Lord of mercy, you paid for it.
First down, Michigan State.
World Series tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern time. San Francisco at Oakland. Oakland A's, with all those hammer throwers and spectacular pitching all year. San Francisco, some say, a team of destiny. They have done things that nobody expected. Yeah, I think it'll be a great series. I don't see any reason in the world why it wouldn't be. This is Ezor catching the pass short underneath the coverage and picks up a couple of yards. J.J. Grant is not willing to yield. And it's 5:55 to go in the third quarter of play. And George Perlis says yesterday, in talking about his quarterback, he was satisfied with him.
Any guy that completes 20 out of 25 against the air is a pretty good day's work. He did that last week. He's carrying a 71% completion average right now. He makes good, smart decisions. He has only had a few turnovers, so we're happy with him and still know that he can get better every week. He still has this year and next year.
He needs to get better this week. Ball is thrown, really, for the first. That's far and away, I think, the best pass he's thrown all day, because that one had to go some distance and they had something on it.
Well, he had some receivers that were open, and the secondary right here, receiver's going to go down and break to the inside. And the reason you're open, you've got man-to-man coverage with these linebackers up front, and they're not dropping back into coverage. Bottom of your screen going into the middle. It's a little square in route. It's the first time that he's had some receivers open downfield in a long time.
And it's first down at the Michigan 49. Here comes Ezor again. Bobby Abrams has him pinned in on the boundary side, and he isn't going anywhere.
Ezor,
his father moved here this year to live with Blake during the season to kind of settle him down, keep him out of trouble. Ezor had five iguanas living with him last year. Got a 4.5-foot boa constrictor. He says, I don't get close to him. He says, he's kind of mean. Who feeds
you?
Maybe he has a deal with a vet school. This is only the third time that the Spartans have been in Michigan territory today. That's not a very clean handoff between Enos and Ezor. And as a result, he gets a late start. And it's going to bring up third down and a yard and a half. Give him a little more than the 40, so it'll be third down and a yard. He has it at the Michigan 35. Bobby Abrams, the tackle. Here you go. A touchdown in the closing moments of this third quarter. Michigan will then turn around and have the wind at their back.
Well, this is what they need. This is their second drive of the second half. They need some kind of sustained drive to take the momentum back, move the ball down, and get a touchdown. You know, Perlis calls Ezor pound for pound the toughest guy he's ever seen.
Well, there's some tough dudes wearing white out there, too, like J.J. Grant and Alex Marshall. Ball is at the 32. Second down. And leaving is Chris Hutchinson for Michigan. Gonna have to rewind Chris here for a second.
Second and seven.
Mike Evans replaces him. Enos roll out. Sideline. Good first down. Throwing to Hawkins, the sophomore from Flint.
Enos complete.
And they'll move the chains. This is the most impressive move that Michigan State has made all day.
It's one of the things that Enos did last week against Iowa is get outside the pocket. He's going to roll to our left, throw on the run. You move the pocket, the protection's a little bit better, and there's no tough reads downfield. You just say, I'm going to throw it to the flanker when he gets open or if he gets open, and if he doesn't, I'm just going to continue running.
First down from the 22. Ezor cuts back. In the backfield is Tripp Welber, number three, blitzing strong safety.
Exactly. This is the area. Michigan's got the offense pushed down their throat the entire field. They say, enough of this. We're going to start attacking. Our backs are to the wall. Let's go after them aggressively, and here comes the blitz.
At the 21.
Yeah, that bend don't break business. It only works. It only applies so far. Second down, 13. Little rollout. Enos gets away from Brett White and runs down to the 15-yard line. White had him dead cold, and he just ducked under it.
And White, as he leaves the field, as you mentioned, had a shot at him, but just Enos being smaller and quicker. There's a naked reverse and a big move by Enos to avoid the loss of yardage and bring it up in a third down situation where they can make it.
The 285-pound guard, Eric Moten, has had to come off the field for Michigan State. Toby Heaton has replaced him. He's a redshirt freshman. Enos gives to Ezor, cuts it back into traffic, and he's going to have a first down for Michigan State. Now the crowd is into it. Before this possession by Michigan State, they only had 13 yards on the ground. They've hammered out 43 in this possession.
And nothing in this drive has been easy, Keith. It's all been short to medium plays. Nothing over, I think the one pass was like 13, 15 yards. But other than that, it was all short stuff and nothing easy.
It's first down and goal from the Michigan 8. Ezor again. He's to the four. Mike Evans brings him down.
Keep in mind that Michigan's defense has given up only one rushing touchdown all year.
Enos taking a long time to get his offensive play call. There's the time ticking away in the third quarter. Second down and goal inside the five. Just inside. Ezor. They'll mark him at the three. And you'll have Todd Plate, Alex Marshall, and Veda Murray all there.
Nothing is easy against Michigan inside. Here's the safety. He's going to blitz to the inside. The linebacker's going to come outside, forcing Ezor to turn it back up inside. That's where Murray, 27, will come up and fill the gap.
Timeout. 10 seconds to go. Third quarter. It's a Michigan State timeout. They'll be looking at third down and goal from the Michigan 3 when we come back. The Lake Superior State, they usually get things jacked up and come on to win the conference and get themselves in the playoffs.
So. Tony Mandrich, an outstanding skater, a player, a hockey player.
Well, he strapped on the skates for a little while until somebody found out about it.
Probably looked
George
like
George found out.
Probably looked like
life.
The Zamboni out there.
He's pretty good. Well, if they run here,
I think you got to get some points on the board. If they don't make it here, they got to kick the field goal. They got to get some points on the board. But they both teams have had a long time to talk it over. You work on this all week, offensive goal line offense. So Michigan State knows what they want to run in the situation.
Moten is back. They've run 15 plays in this possession, used more than 7 minutes. Here's the try for the TD, and they don't get there.
They're going to be close enough that it's going to be a tough decision. I mean, they were on about the 3.5-4 yard line. They're going to get close to about inside the one, and this is going to make it a tough decision. No, he's about the 1.5 yard line.
Well, you've got the end of the third quarter, which will give them time to ponder it. But it's 10-0 Michigan, and right now the decision time belongs to Michigan State. Lights on here. Yep, we did bring in portable lights because the game going on today, the cloud layer has been a little thicker today than it was yesterday. Brilliantly clear yesterday. And so here's Michigan State now backed up inside their 35 when it appeared they were going to have very, very good field position. But their history on the season in this quarter has not been good. Working into the wind. This is Ezor. And he's got 3 yards, and that'll do it as Eric Anderson brings him down. And here's Roger Carter.
Thank you very much, Keith. It's hot in Tucson, Arizona, 102 on the field, and the Bruins of UCLA are suffering. Brett Johnson going deep. Look at the interception by Hammerschmidt, his second of the day. The Bruins have scored in 210 consecutive games, an NCAA record. They trail 35-0 in the fourth. Back to you, Keith.
Thank you, Rod. Those cats will claw you to submission on their home field, especially. Pass thrown to the fullback. Nope, tight end, Dwayne Young, finally gets to see the ball. He's the second receiver on the team coming into the ball game, and that's the first time they have thrown the ball in his direction today.
Young came in with 10 receptions, as you mentioned, the second leading receiver on the team. Keith, the psychology in that huddle now has got to be something very tough. They've got to really force themselves. They took it all the way down the last drive, came away with nothing. It's very tough to get something going. They've got to force themselves to get something going on this drive.
First down at the 48. Dan Enos has time, goes down the middle. It's good. Hawkins pulled it in at the 35-yard line. Tripp Welborn the tackle.
Pass complete. Dan Enos to Courtney Hawkins.
Enos with a good throw. Take a look at the pass protection from the end zone. Moten and Pearson, Keller, lots of time over the linebackers and in front of the defensive backs. You're going to get hit when you throw a square in like that, and Welber did.
Enos 11 out of 14 for 103 yards. He's hit six in a row. Rolls out to buy some time. White misses him, throws the ball into the ground. Well, I didn't There was nobody available. The only possibility would have been 43 Montgomery off to the left side, but he had no chance to see him.
George Perlis in the Big Ten the last few years, awfully good. That includes a trip to the Rose Bowl and a victory. But I like what Enos is doing. Outside the pocket, running around, not standing inside the pocket, gives him more time. The play doesn't have to be perfect when you're outside the pocket.
From the 35, second down and 10 for the Spartans. Enos has got a little room. He's got a first down at the Michigan 22.
Defensive line slants for Michigan. The slanting defensive line, Ezor play action, and Enos play action pass. Grant's going to come around from his linebacker spot, number 95, flushes him out, and this is one of the things that Michigan State is starting to do, take advantage of the mobility of its quarterback.
Chris Hutchinson back in the defensive lineup now for Michigan. This is Ezor. Hutchinson misses him, and he's knocked out. A stride inside the 20 by Tripp Welborn, who's playing up a storm in that defensive secondary now for Michigan. And here's Jack.
Keith, it's amazing how much the emotions have shifted from one side to the other in this second half. All through the first half, it was all Michigan, and they felt it, and you could feel it when you were on their side of the bench. Throughout the second half here, though, you can feel the electricity down here on the Michigan State side. Sure, the score is still 10 to zip, but the moves that they have made have got everybody electrified, and they feel they're back in the hunt.
Second down, 7. Ezor, little hesitation, and he never got his wheels grinding again. And he runs into Mike Teeter.
I think the
JJ Grant.
The reason that emotion is on the side of the Spartans is because of Perlis at halftime getting these guys fired up. Michigan came with another safety blitz that time, and this is the area, as we've mentioned before, where they like to come and try to push you back.
Hickson is in the lineup. Pass is incomplete, intended for Montgomery, and they're very lucky that was not picked off. Okay.
So there was nobody open. There was coverage good all over the place.
Anderson on the play for Michigan.
Take a look at the pass protection. It's excellent. Just good coverage downfield is what made Enos. You can see there's nobody open. He had to throw it over Anderson, number 37. Almost was an outstanding catch.
Langlow will try for 3 this time. 10:50 to play in the game. And it's going to be a 34-yarder. Butland holds it. Wind has quieted it down a little bit. The kick is no good. Left. Well, very few things have gone well for the Michigan State Spartans so far today. The Michigan State Spartans have to be almost at the point of the primal scream.
Well, Michigan has controlled the second half, but somebody has got to step forward and make a play. If it's a field goal, the kicker has to make it. If it's a touchdown, the running back has got to get in some way or other, or the quarterback has got to throw a pass.
All right, 20-yard line for the Wolverines. They still lead it 10 to nothing. Elvis Gerbach gives it to Tony Bowles. Tony Bowles runs through a great big hole. I mean, you could have run the Sunday Surrey through that one over the left side, and he picks up about 12 yards. Bo Schembechler. Does this game represent the first turn of the key toward winning a conference title? This is what he said yesterday.
Illinois still is looming out there, and we have to play both Iowa and Illinois on the road. And we play Ohio State, Michigan State does not. I would say, from that standpoint, I don't think we could lose a game in the conference and expect to be a contender. If we don't win this game, it'd be real hard for us to win the championship.
Forward on the carry. Michigan goes to Iowa next week. We'll have it for you here on ABC Sports. Illinois will come into East Lansing to play the Spartans. Illinois struggled today against Purdue, finally winning it 14-2.
Amazing about Schembeck, though, this is his 20th year at Michigan. He never had a losing season. And 19 of those 20 years, he's won at least 8 games.
That's Tony Bowles. Not much. A yard. Carlos Jenkins leading the play. A junior from Boynton Beach, Florida.
We talked about State's inability to score. Of course, you've got to give credit to Michigan's defense. They have held up inside the 20 in the second half 2 times. And now the offense, and powered behind that offensive line, is really taking charge. If they make some first downs here, the ball game's over with. They don't need points. They need first downs to take time off the clock.
Pretty good day for Tony Bowles. Michigan's last 5 possessions, they've had the punt. This is 3rd down. And Gerbach's pass is complete to the 40 to Derek Walker in the arms of Percy Snow. He's going to be short of the first down. There is still time. Well, they want to measure to make sure as they put the ball down. There is still time for Michigan State at 8:45 to play in the game. But I don't know how many times you can go to the well. How many times you can walk into the huddle and clap your hands and say, let's go, guys, when you've gone forever and ever and ever and ever and so many opportunities and come away
empty.
Well,
it's getting to the point now when your backs are to the wall, so you just try anything. And so let's just give it all we've got. And sometimes that's what happens. Sometimes you get the ball 12, 13, 14 possessions, and it's the last 2 possessions of the game that you score on.
I thought Derek Walker got a pretty good mark on the ball, but it's still going to be short of the first down. Los Angeles Rams to Buffalo Bills. ABC's Monday Night Football next Monday at 9 Eastern time. Rams are the NFL's only undefeated team, and they're looking at a frothing, foaming, fire in the belly defense in Buffalo.
Buffalo needs to win, too.
Yes, they certainly do. Michigan now will be punting in its last 6 possessions. Stapleton. Hawkins deep. Here they come. Block it. They got it. Harlan Barnett, I think, was the man. Boy, they turned him loose that time. You got a Spartan down on the field.
Well, the Spartans don't have much more to lose from the bottom. Looks like Barnett, 36, yeah. Barnett has had a big year so far, and he hasn't even played half the season. He's intercepted 2 passes, recovered 2 fumbles, and run one back for a touchdown.
That's Alan Haller. He's all right, walking off the field. And there's the man that got his hand on it, number 36, Harlan Barnett. And so Michigan State owns the ball and another opportunity.
There's a motor oil that talks about quality, always has, always will. Well, Valvoline makes the highest quality motor oil recommended by any automobile manufacturer. Oh yeah, unlike the competition, Valvoline now has a $2 check that works just like cash when you buy 6 quarts or more of Valvoline or get an oil change using Valvoline. Look for your Valvoline check in magazines or your mailbox. People who know, use Valvoline.
Which compact passenger van helps you stop best on the slippery curves you drive on? Chevy Astro or Ford Aerostar? Chevy's standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes help you make controlled stops. Ford doesn't offer four-wheel anti-lock brakes. And look what can happen if the front wheels skid during braking. So stop and think. Chevy Astro gives you the technology of four-wheel anti-lock brakes. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Defending Big Ten champ Michigan tackles perennial power Iowa. Or UCLA hits the Oregon Trail to take on Oregon State. Next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
Well, the Aggies just cannonized and shut down, you all, the run and shoot. Here's a very revealing stat, I think. 17 plays, nothing, 9 plays, nothing, and in the process, about 12 and a half minutes off the clock for Michigan State. And now they've got it again. This is their best field position for a starting possession with 8:25 to play in the game. Michigan leading 10 to nothing, and Enos rolls it out and throws good. Oh, get out of bounds. Courtney Hawkins, not going out of bounds, turned it back inside and wound up losing 2 yards. If he just steps out of bounds, he's another 2 yards down the field.
Eno seems to be much happier outside the pocket. This time he's going to fake the duck at 35, get outside. Easier to read the coverage, and you're closer to your receiver. This receiver is double covered. Still, he gets the ball there because he's closer to it.
See, there he loses 2 yards.
Yep.
Football is basically the acquisition of real estate. And when you're at this point in a game, it's like buying property on the Malibu coast. You buy it by the foot. You don't want to give up anything, right? Hyland Hickson is in the lineup now. They send Montgomery in motion. Enos is back to throw it. Shoots it down the middle. Pass is thrown behind the intended receiver, Courtney Hawkins. That was a bad pass.
This is almost like the old basketball box and one. Everybody else is playing a zone. Dotton, 22, is following Hawkins the entire way. Obviously, Michigan knows something about the passing schemes for Michigan State, knowing that he is the man they want to get the ball to.
Throws the ball to the left hand, to his left hand instead of his right hand. He probably gets it. Yeah. Enos down in the grasp of Marshall. Alex Marshall, J.J. Grant ran him out and right into Marshall.
That's the inexperience of a young quarterback and a nice play by Marshall. That's his second sack on the day. Enos, when he gets in this situation, should throw it downfield and avoid the sack at all costs. There's Grant, 95, flushing him out. Throw it now. Don't take the sack. Michigan has tremendous team speed. We talked about earlier, this is a team defense. Nobody on that Michigan defense is in the top 20 in the Big Ten in individual tackle.
Loss of 7 yards. He got it. Caught by Bradley. Bradley's elbow was sharper than Keys, and he caught the ball. Watch him go up and hammer David Key with his left elbow just as he makes the catch. But that's the point. You got to fight for it. And he outfought him.
The first time, top of your screen, Key is to the right. First time Michigan State's throwing deep all day. Key's got good coverage. He just slips. Right here he slips. Bradley sees it, goes up and makes the play. You've got 22 players on the field. But when you throw that type, it's my man against your man, one-on-one.
36-yard pickup, 11-yard line, first down Michigan State, and here goes Hickson. And he doesn't have any more luck than the other people have tried that today. The other person, actually, that being Blake Ezor. Though Hickson is the bigger man at 210 pounds. But old Rip Welborn, sitting right there in the trenches, belted him for a yard loss. Welborn has had a big ball game.
Bunch of those Wolverines that have had big days. Marshall, Grant, Murray. Flick.
into the corner, too far. Intended for Bradley, and he overthrew him out of the end zone. Key coverage. Well, I presume he had the matchup he wanted. Key is 5'10", and Bradley is 6 feet. Not much insofar as height was concerned, but since Bradley won the last tussle, he thought he'd try it again.
Well, there's a mistake he made. He just threw it out of the end zone. Didn't give his man a chance.
Nickelback is in now, Otis Williams, and that takes Bobby Abrams, an outside linebacker, out of the ball game. And you're looking at third down and 11 from the 12. And timeout. Michigan State. And the Wolverines will what? Have one left. They have one left. The time remaining is 5 minutes and 59 seconds. Michigan dominating the game up through the middle of the third quarter. Then it sort of turned a little bit. They had that long drive. Came up 15, 17 plays, then 9 plays. So what you had is a total of 26 plays and 2 separate possessions. Nothing to show for it. But having some luck, they have come back to knock one more time.
And Perlis has been through these situations before. He was 10 years as a defensive line coach with the Steelers, defensive coordinator, 4 championship rings. Says the guy that had the biggest influence on him was Chuck Knoll.
Next Saturday, Big Ten game will be Michigan at Iowa. The West Coast game will be UCLA at Oregon State. 3:30 Eastern Time. It'll be 12:30 out on the West Coast for the Bruins and the Beavers. That's in Corvallis, I think. All right, third down. And 11 from the 12. And Enos looks and looks and looks and throws. It's caught at the 5 by Hawkins. Caught it right in front of Todd Plate. Now it is fourth down.
Ball on the 4. It is fourth down and 3.
Well, these are tough decisions for Perlis. You've gone for it on the 1 and didn't make it for a touchdown. You had your field goal kicker try it already and he's missed. He's had one blocked earlier in the game and then he missed a field goal. You've got 5 minutes to go. You go for the touchdown. You got single coverage out here on the right. You may just throw it out here to
Hickson is out of the backfield. He's in the end zone. The pass to the corner. Touchdown. Hawkins.
He's in here tight. You spread him out. You run a little quick out, and you take your chances one-on-one. You go in. You make a move to the inside. Sprint out a little bit. A lot of time because you're outside the pocket, and that's a big play for Michigan State. They're right back in the ball game after having been frustrated offensively for 3.5 quarters.
If he went for 2 here, you might have a chance to win. Instead, he's going to go for the 1, which is good. And now he's in a position where a field goal could get him a tie. But remember, these are 2 teams that are playing for the Big Ten Conference title. Sometimes a tie can serve you well.
Out here, people depend on Craftsman. Craftsman tools are so tough, the hand tools are guaranteed forever. So you can...
Making the reception... He's had a pretty good day. Finally, they break the ice.
Hawkins was a freshman last year. One of the 2 players to letter was the Michigan High School Player of the Year 2 years ago.
For Michigan.
And gets the Michigan 21. State Spartans right back in the ballgame.
5:09 to play. Langlow kicking, and it's Bowles and Desmond Howard. Bowles to the right and Howard on the left. Into the wind, they're going to creep up a little bit near the 10-yard line. Michigan's got big people up on the front. Onside kick. Kicked it on the ground. I know that didn't work at all. I mean, that didn't work at all. It went right straight to Bernie Leggett, a fullback, and Leggett runs it back up to the 38-yard line.
Well, that's why you have fullback in that position.
That's right.
In case they squib it, you can field it and not fall down, but get some yardage out.
Kickoff returned by Bernie Leggett.
Leggett, a true freshman, by the way, the backup fullback.
Why wouldn't you have just aimed it right at one of those great big old tackles up on the front and whacked him with it? You'd have had a chance. Maybe. You'd have been in about the same position if you'd have kicked it right at one of those big lines. Yard line. Michigan's ball. Big series right here for the Michigan State defense. 5:05 to play in the ball game. Give it to Tony Bowles. That's a lot of hard work by Bowles, and finally, they get him. Benson Donaldson, playing the boundary side corner, did a good job in forcing him back inside. And with the 2-yard pickup, Bowles now goes to 100 yards. That's the Big Ten today. Not quite far enough along as yet, I don't think, to really talk a whole lot about where they stand, but after next week you will be.
The Michigan State needs a turnover. They lead the Big Ten in taking the ball away.
Second down and 8 from the 40. Gerbach back, lets it go to the sidelines, and McMurtry's there for the first down. Turned and caught the ball in front of Alan Heller.
Big throw and big catch for Michigan.
Michigan.
Shows you the confidence that Schembechler has in this young man, Gerbach. Play action holds the linebackers. You're going to have one-on-one on the outside. McMurtry with all kinds of speed. That tells me that he's got a lot of confidence in Gerbach.
44-yard line, Michigan State side of the field. 10-7, Wolverines lead. Here's Hord, the fullback, and Leroy punches across the 40. They'll call it a 4-yard pickup. Michigan State with only one timeout remaining. And every inch that Michigan moves the ball from right to left makes the journey longer and longer for Michigan State.
Keith, this is why you have to be able to run the football and be a winning team. If you can't run the football here, if Michigan couldn't run, they've got to turn it over and give it back. But if you can run the football in a situation, your defense may never have to play, get on the field again.
Tony Bowles wrapped up by Travis Davis. A loss back to the 41-yard line. Big Travis punched his way right in there.
Michigan State 40.
And a sprint draw. Travis Davis beats Dingman, number 78.
And that's news.
Yep. Dingman has had a good game.
2:50 to play. Michigan 3 out of 13 in third down conversions. Gerbach back. Looks for Callaway. No. Short. It fell between Horde and Callaway. And it's fourth down. This will be the 7th punt for Stapleton today. His last one was blocked.
Stapleton is the Michigan punter.
Hawkins is standing up at the 10. He thinks he's going to pooch kick it. He almost got that one blocked. Hawkins, a fair catch at the 12. And I mean, that was just a whisker away from being stuffed, too. And so Michigan State gets the ball back. 2:36 to play in the game, 88 yards away from the Michigan goal line. One other little note to tuck away. Any field goal try by Langlo will be into the wind.
And he's not in the best of moods right now, having had one block and one miss. But this is what you work on in practice. You say, all right, here's our two-minute drill. We've got 2.5 minutes to play. You have one timeout, and we need at least a touchdown, at least a field goal to tie a touchdown to win.
Hickson and Ezor both out of the backfield. Pass thrown underneath to Montgomery. He catches the ball up around the 16-yard line, and there Eric Anderson takes him down.
Tackled by Mike Evans.
Enos is throwing against the best pass defense in the Big Ten and the number 5 ranked pass defense in the country. Michigan, very tough to throw against. Enos is 16 of 23 and 105 yards.
It's actually second down and 6. That's a good pass, but it's tipped away and incomplete. It looked for a moment like Hawkins would be able to curl in between them. But suddenly there was J.J. Grant, and he almost had another interception.
J.J. Grant weighs 245 pounds, had major knee surgery last year. The leader of this team made it back and almost skied high enough. He skied high enough. He just didn't have the hands for it.
Third and 6. Depends on the mark.
It'll be close.
Pure judgment. Well, for the linesman.
If you don't make it, you've got to go for it. There's no doubt about that.
Tight end Dwayne Young, second catch of the day. They'll measure. Time remaining, 1:43.
You can see that it's short if they bring that chain in the correct way.
Gotta go.
Short of the first down. Miami. 4-1. Less than 1 from the 22.
The length of the football.
This is a tailback offense. Ezor, Duckett, Hickson. They've all gained over 100 yards in their career, all tailbacks.
This figures to be the play of the game right here for the Michigan State Spartans.
The first of many, maybe.
Yeah. If they make it, fine. But if they don't, it's almost, I'll see you later. I'll see you next year. Enos the quarterback, and he'll have it. And as a Michigan man hurt, it's Grant. J.J. Grant holding a leg. Oh, my goodness. That is a big figure in the scheme of things defensively for the Michigan Wolverines. He's coming off of an injury, and he's hurting right now.
24.
Right there.
It's his foot caught.
Enos pass thrown upfield to the 30-yard line on first down is good for about 6. And that left leg, the hyperextension at least of J.J. Grant, he has been helped from the field.
He walked off, was not carried off, so that's good news.
Second down, four. Hickson. That's a first down across the 40 to the 41.
Hickson has some speed.
Tackled by Anderson.
Just throwing a little check down to those backs. You may get more out of it if you can break a tackle from one of those linebackers.
106 left to play in the ball game. Back goes Enos. Penalty flags all over the field. Enos running around. Probably holding coming up. Pass is complete to Bradley. He's down to the Michigan 36. Penalty flags are thrown back upfield.
Thing about the whole play is Enos makes things happen when he's outside the pocket. Gives his receivers more time to do something.
You got a face mask and it's against Michigan State. So in the process of trying to protect Enos, somebody grabbed a face mask.
It was 68. Pearson, I think, that had a hold of Teeter. Yeah. No, 52 right next to him. Yeah.
Keller.
They were both blocking him up around the helmet area.
Oh, does that hurt?
Personal foul.
Because the pass was good. Michigan State. It could have been. First down, Michigan State at the Michigan 36.
Yeah.
What about J.J. Grant, Jack?
Well, Keith, we're checking on J.J. Grant, trying to get the latest word.
Knee injury. I don't know really the extent of it yet. It's a significant knee injury.
They are going to take him off the field, though, Keith, by a golf cart, because that left knee has swollen considerably.
Yeah, it's probably a ligament. There's a pass thrown upfield to Hawkins. Hawkins at the 40. Back to the original line of scrimmage.
They say he did not get out of bounds.
Did not. And the clock continues to run.
And that is critical. You need to take a timeout now. These seconds you're losing, you'll never get them back.
Inside 30, 28 seconds. Enos, pressure, White knocks the ball loose. Ball rolling around. Incomplete pass, they call it. Incomplete forward pass. Referee called it right away. It was Brent White who hit it. The rule book simply says the interpretation factor is this year, if there is any suggestion of a forward pass, so shall it be called.
Here's Enos in the pocket again. He's not comfortable in the pocket. He doesn't see things happening. He doesn't see the man coming. He raises his arm to start the passing motion. Ron Winter, the referee, right behind him, calls it an incomplete pass.
Ball went forward, and there was some movement. That was enough. J.J. Grant may be gone for the season. That really a big loss if he is. Third down and a little more than 10. White fighting his way in there. They flushed Enos. Now he's got White after him. He's got Marshall after him. He throws the ball. The ball is caught by the tight end, Dwayne Young. Young gets out of bounds.
No, he doesn't.
They don't call him out of bounds. The clock is still going. He doesn't have a first down.
That was a good call. He hit the ground in bounds, but the other one was questionable. Forces them to use their last timeout.
Yeah, but they've only got 6 seconds remaining.
Yep.
So they are now at the point where a win or even a tie represents miracle for Michigan State. Ball is at the 47-yard line of Michigan State. They got 6 seconds to play with.
Well, the only thing you can do here is throw the Hail Mary. If you're trying to hit a down and out, it's going to take 6 seconds to complete it.
Well, Langlo's career long is 51 yards against Northwestern back in 1987. So
from the Michigan State 48.
This could be the final play of the ball game, with Michigan leading Michigan State 10-7, and Dan Enos rolls it out and throws interception. Picked off by Lance Dutton, and the Michigan Wolverines have defeated the Michigan State Spartans by a score of 10-7.
Michigan State
The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game are J.J. Grant, 13 tackles plus an interception and an injury, unfortunately. Travis Davis for Michigan State, 9 tackles in the ball game and a lot of hurries. It was a day and a game, indeed, for the big uglies in the trenches. It was finally became the kind of a game that we all thought it would be. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. All right, here's Jack.
Well, congratulations. Well, it was a tough victory, but it was a victory. Anytime you can win up here on the road, it's a big game.
You really dodged a couple of serious bullets, though, today. They drove, and they couldn't close it in.
Well, that's true, but by the same token, the same things that they had happened to them in the second half, we had happened to us in the first. Otherwise, I think we could have scored some more.
You had intimated that maybe Michael Taylor would start, but this fella here, Elvis Gerback, played the whole way. Had a heck of a game.
Well, once you get on top, you don't want to switch quarterbacks, so that's the reason we stayed with Elvis.
Elvis, you had a terrific drive today. You really did a fine, fine job. Any problems with any part of your game?
I think we just wanted to come into the game with the running game. And, I mean, all during the week we were talking about that, and that's where we established and get a couple passes there and there, and everything really worked out for us.
You've had some really tough games, and you've shown your mettle as a quarterback. Did this one bring you over the line and really establish it?
With a big game like this, I just wanted to play within myself, and that's what I did, and everything really went fine for me.
Keith, that's the story from here in midfield.
So the Wolverines are now 2-0 in the conference. They go to Iowa City against the Hawkeyes next Saturday.
The University of Michigan student athletes exemplify the talent and preparation that identify Michigan alumni as leaders. Michigan's extensive research base and exceptional faculty prepare students from Michigan and from around the world to meet challenges they'll face in the 21st century. In the classroom or on the playing field, Michigan students are committed to achieving the high level of success that comes from all-out effort. That's a Michigan tradition.
Well, the big crowd of 76,913 are going to walk a little slowly, I think, if you're wearing green and white, because their folks lost by 3 points. Final score was 10-7. Our spotter, Todd Barry, statistician Dave Burnson. And now, the Michigan Wolverines are kind of in the catbird seat in the Big Ten Conference. If they can go on the road and win one more, they'll really be in the catbird seat. Final score again, Wolverines win it 10-7.